हेलो नमस्ते सलाम वालेकुम सत श्री अकाल वेलकम बैक टू अनदर सेशन विथ योर वाशफ एट वारेवा.com. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू मेक सांबार बट यूजिंग ओनली रैडिश. यू नो रैडिश सांबार इज वन ऑफ द फेमस सांबार. पीपल एट होम मेक दिस एंड दे थरोली एंजॉय. सम पीपल जस्ट दे हैव टू ऐड रैडिश इन द सांबार बट हियर वी गोइंग टू ऐड लॉट ऑफ रैडिश. एंड ऑल्सो टुडे आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू ऐड जैगरी. Traditionally what I add, you know, and the masalas are also are ready to use masalas. Only thing I'm adding is coconut milk. If you do not want to add coconut milk, still you can make it. So first, to make this radish sambar, I'm going to take some oil in a pan. And for this, I'm going to start with adding mustard seeds. And when the mustard seeds splatter, we're going to add red chilies. Add cumin seeds. You're going to add a lot of curry leaf. Green chili, and I did forget to add fenugreek seeds, that is methi leaves, very little. You know, methi seeds always add very little. In this, we're going to add hing, turmeric, and also in this, not the onions cut into big piece, just the slice of onion, a little bit. And when the onions saute a little bit, now you add radish. You know, radish cut into roundels, that's the way I'm used to eating at home. And now just mix. If the radish is quite fat, then you can cut into halves and cut into halves. So now we're going to let this radish get sauteed a little bit in the oil for around 2 to 3 minutes. Now we're going to add pieces of tomatoes and add water. Yes, a lot of water, because we are making a lot of sambar here. And in this we're going to add coriander powder, very little of cumin powder, red chili powder, and also we're going to add coconut milk to this. This is optional. If you have, you can add. We're going to put the lid on. You know, we're going to let this boil for around 20 minutes till the radish is soft and the tomatoes are all totally mashed up. After around 20 minutes of cooking, my radish is all nice and soft. But first, now we're going to add tamarind juice. Tamarind juice, always be careful, do not add too much, just add little if you are not very sure how much to add, because you can always add little more later to adjust the sourness. But if it is too sour, you know, you won't like. But anyway, the amount of sourness is very subjective. Some people like it little more sour, some people like it just little bit. Now after adding tamarind juice, we need to cook for another 4-5 minutes. So I'm going to let it cook for another 4-5 minutes. Now the tamarind juice is after adding tamarind juice, that is when you get real nice aroma from this cooking sambar. In this, we just cook the tuvar dal till it is nice and mashed. You know, you don't mash the tuvar dal. It has to be, you know, cooked till that consistency. That's when you will get a very nice tasty sambar. And as usual, I'm not adding jaggery into it, because the coconut milk gives that little sweetness that should be good enough for this sambar, radish sambar. And once this comes to a nice boil, we're going to add some chopped coriander. In the end, we're going to add a little more salt and adjust the seasoning. Okay? And now the sambar is all. You know, look at this, lot of radish. In this, the radish tastes so good that I just love this radish sambar. So, dear friends, you know, sambar can be made hundreds of variations. And one of the favorite is radish, drumstick, just onion sambar. Like that, there are some of them which are really, really great. All of them are great, but these really stand out and taste so good. So, you know, enjoy it with pieces of, you know, this sambar. And you've seen that we don't add too much masalas or anything in this. Very simple, with a lot of radish in it. So, take extra radish when you eat this, that's when you will thoroughly enjoy. And this sambar, because of the radish, it gets a very awesome flavor. Just outstanding. Along with this, a piece of papad. Wow, super. But look at the radish pieces, nice. They become nice and juicy and very tasty with a little bit of tamarind juice and all this. This is why I love radish sambar. Dear friends, I hope you enjoyed today's session, but do not forget, Vareva is all about inspiring others to cook. So please post your recipes and cooking tips at vareva.com so others can benefit from your great cooking. Wow. Now I can enjoy it with my hand.